I want to use the pandas.
Uh-huh.
I want to kind of throw them in your path to push you out of the clouds and have them sacrifice themselves.
Wow. Get rid of the pandas.
Wow.
Well, we got to get rid of them because, you know, can't have toxic waste just lying around.
Right.
I feel like one would eat the other one. Just when you have like a ship full of rats.
Yeah. That's what I mean. It's like we can get rid of the cloud or the pandas. No matter what.
We're solving two problems. The pandas actually were able. The pandas were able to suck up and eat all of the energy for the nuclear plant. They could probably do that with the toxic cloud as well.
And they're already.
Keep in mind, the nuclear plant was radioactive. This is clearly acidic.
Oh yeah, that's true. That's
so
true.
It'll just kill them outright. Yeah. So I still don't see a downside.
Yeah. Well, I mean, they are mutants. We're some solving mutants a problem. Might be resistant to.
They're overpopulated. We need to thin out these panda numbers.
Do you know how many rabid giant pandas there are with fly wings? In this world,
if they're not gonna reproduce by themselves, they don't deserve to survive as a species.
They need to help themselves.
Okay. That was actually General Cortez's whole plan.
You're gonna send the pandas after him to try and
to wrangle him out of there.
All right,
provide a panda barrier between him and the clouds.
That is your wastewater action, of course. Mm-hmm. So that's a D12.
Chad asks you the problem.
Two D6s for pandas.
Sorry.
Are you going to use any equipment or activate any powers?
Yeah, I want to use my ancient artifact of panda handling.
Oh, of course.
Well, it's a totem.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Yeah. Well, I finally had it upside down for a long time. Figured it out.
You know, once you saw them, you realize which way the pictures were supposed to go. Oh, they're wings. Not these weird blobs that walk on their noses?
Exactly. What do I get for that? That's a 10 or 8?
That's a 10. Your artifact is 10, yeah.
Okay, and...
You going to activate a power or not?
Sure. I'm having a hard time using it, so no. I'm going to say no.
Great. So the pandas could just eat Sean. So that's a D6 danger.
Let's so we're kind of solving for three Sean. Problems.
Sure, I guess.
Hey, you're welcome, by the way, for diving and hitting my head on the ground on a cinder block.
You're such a self-righteous fuck at Dash Run. Really want to see.
I feel like there's a danger here where...
Of the Hopley fortune.
It has been established that when Sean is under duress, he can mentally link people. And I feel like he might mentally link the pandas to you guys.
When you do that.
Honestly, that's my go-to.
Mind swap.
Whenever we're in trouble, I'm like, let's link us all together and see what happens.
I heard a million pandas scream out in agony, and then we're silenced.
And then I think finally the pandas could just turn on you and go fuck yourself, I'm going to eat you instead.
No, yeah. I've got an artifact
of panda handling.
The radiation has given us extreme sentience.
That's just literally soapstone that you've carved into a panda. That's nothing.
Let's roll it.
They're not impressed.
Just now.
Okay. Well,
No.
Three and
no,
four?
No bueno.
Not good.
Three so success, four failure.
Four failures. Whoa. All right. Give yourself...
Hold on.
Do plus one hit against weather, ruins, trap, or beast threat. Does the clouds and the pandas count as beast weather threats?
Well, the clouds are definitely some sort of weather threat.
Okay, so can I add a one to one of those?
Actually, no, you get one additional hit. So
yeah, it's 4 and 4.
Yeah, so it's 4 and 4.
Okay, better than 3 and 4.
Yeah.
All right, so you mark off 4 danger.
Yay, I get a thing.
Oh, I'm trying to remember the order of operations.
What? That just sounded.
I've never used one of those, so I don't know what to do with it.
Say a number.
2.
1, 2. I messed up. I didn't put numbers. Are
yeah, don't
letters.
Choose
that one.
Oh,
yeah. I was like, oh, yeah.
Okay, give me a
little. Okay, it's fine.
All right.
Pick a letter.
Okay, great.
A, B, C, D.
So now C. You take a full hit. What are you at on your danger meter?
I'm barely in Bashed. I'm about to leave Bashed.
Oh, okay. All right. So you do take a point
gets canceled.
Of Bashed.
Um,
All right, so here's what happens.
Yeah, take that ozone layer. Yeah.
Suck it. The pandas do like fly, like you're like, fetch! And they're like, and they slowly hurl themselves, and they go up into the cloud, and you see them kind of like grab onto the magna grapple that Fuiha is holding.
Oh,
kind
boy.
Chomp!
Just panda skeletons.
You hear this loud sound of teeth sinking into buttocks.
I have a butt shield.
Is it always active?
No.
It's a passive ability.
No, because I'm smart enough to know there are times when you don't want your butt to be protected.
But the...
Oh.
You really should cover your ass more.
Wow. Mm-hmm.
That's a mess down here now.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's now start the live stream charity quote book and kick it off with Mr. Sean Graham. I know there are times when you don't want your butt to be protected. Okay.
What is that?
There needs to be like those things they have at businesses, like so many days from an injury or whatever.
Yeah,
like that.
So many days
like,
without a weird quote from Sean.
Yes.
Yeah.
I think
we're
going
to have minutes.
I'm
just imagining like the more you know, like Sean just walks out in like a dark studio.
Because I know a lot of things.
Hey, you see the magna grapple just kind of just like a whoa, back and forth. And all of a sudden there's this huge thunderclap, right? And Sean falls out of the sky. And of course. Dash, run, hop, leap. Falls out of the sky. Completely unconscious, however, again, sticks the landing.
Nice.
Perfect 10-point landing. But the two fried pandas come plopping out of the clouds and land on you. And bury Shmoo-tra-loo.
Oh, no!
All right. I feel like we didn't really solve what's causing this toxic cloud.
Isn't it just radiation from the Earth?
We have that, and what happens?
Why do we do all this?
Did we solve the panda problem?
Pandas.
Pretty much
I guess we know what happens to the pandas now. That's true.
Yeah, they get charged.
They're in panda heaven.
Yeah.
There's
no panda heaven.
There's no panda heaven.
Pandas do not go to heaven.
Whites only.
You can either attempt to gain further information about
no
Iron Starak, or attempt to discern what's going on with the toxic cloud.
Racism gets the
Irish. No, I don't want to mess with the toxic cloud, seeing what happened with them. Someone has started on this dude. So I'm going to collect information on this one.
Where did we get that information again? How did we hear that?
Well, that
his diary.
The dream journal. Is the person that
so he might not even be real then.
General Cortez.
Well, no, we're pretty sure it's real because it's written over and over and over and over again.
But what if it's his imaginary friend?
Yeah.
But he's written Crane Cortez.
Exactly.
Crane Cortez.
What if it's his dad?
We just find a room with just that name written all over in newspapers.
Yeah.
A beautiful mind type of connections.
Yeah. All right.
A relative or something.
So what would you like to do to try and figure out who or where this Crane Cortez...
So we're all still in pretty much the throne room, right?
Yeah. Yeah,
are there any other, obviously it's like a fortress, I'm assuming.
Sure.
So let's explore.
Mm-hmm. It's a fortress built in the ruins of a nuclear power plant.
Okay.
So you find obviously he has quarters, the place is sort of slowly evacuating as I will take that suggestion. And as you're wandering through the hall, suddenly you just hear this voice say,
"Ooh, it's me, I lost my friend."
I hate that already.
Oh,
oh no.
Oh my god.
Here for you.
Is it my ancestor's friend, Blueberry Red?
Ooh, it's me, Blueberry Red.
All right.
My friend was a nice Frenchman who was a plant. Now he's dead.
What cereal mascot is this?
I was a friend of plants.
I like you pretty way you talk.
I'm a lovely, nice person, and I'd like to ask you.
It's a cereal mascot.
How do you really like rattle? Like,
Crane Starak.
Start your morning Starak. Off.
Oh, that was a future role. They had
the Razzleberries, or whatever they were called.
I've got
Farnsworth
candy.
Was the bad guy.
Ooh, you have candy?
I've got candy.
I like candy, but I don't have a body.
What?
But if I eat it, you'll taste it.
Could be a shadow being, I mean.
If I eat the candy, you'll taste it. Ooh. Yeah. Do you want to try? Then you can tell me that, and I will always eat candy.
I think I'm getting what you guys are feeling now.
Fui-ha?
Yeah.
It's not me.
So you're just like, fui-ha.
I will be a very nice friend, and you can accompany me on all my adventures. Would you like that?
Nope. I don't. No. No.
You mean I want this. Be with you for the next
2,000 years?
Minutes?
Absolutely.
Oh, God.
Absolutely.
That sounds like too long for that voice.
In the windowless wagon, little girl. Oh,
that is great.
Little
yeah,
child
the
spirit.
Yo boy's sadder cousin.
Gonna be dealing with this fucking blueberry red.
In my windowless.
I have a question. Are we the only ones in the future who just speak normally?
Yeah.
Is this is the normal? Okay. Yeah.
We have to act it up, you know.
Yeah, yeah. I'm pretty sure. Yeah, I'm pretty sure this is the norm, and we're the weird ones now in the future.
Yeah.
Oh no.
Me and Dash Runner.
I'm gonna call this a waste walker action because you are trying to tame and deal with an alien culture.
Right.
Is it just a floating beam of energy?
Okay.
That's pretty good.
Are you going to use any other equipment or abilities?
Well,
Hello,
I'm
Picard.
Not trying to attack
Hello.
Him.
Uh-huh.
Or it.
Look at my
yeah.
super
I guess I could use from beyond to
from
connect
beyond.
From more because it's like right. I'm going to the grave.
I will call
nice.
You're going to the grave?
Well,
is that
not
said?
The grave, but like into the beyond.
Oh, God.
Oh, I didn't know.
Of course.
I didn't know. Did I just... Is that racist?
Neither did Blueberry Red. It just found out it's a ghost.
No, is that racist? I'm not racist,
no.
A ghost.
I'm the ghost of an imaginary friend.
Oh, no. I'm so sorry. God.
Wait, how does that
even Yeah. Died in a car accident.
I'm pretty sure I'm pretty sure the slur for ghosts is gravies.
Gravy. That's so racist.
Reset the counter.
Man, we had made it. What? We had made it like 6
Bunch
minutes.
Of filthy gravies. Taking our job.
So yeah, I guess I'll just use that.
From beyond.
Yeah.
Great. So that'll give you I'll another
D10. Abusing the welfare system.
Exactly. There we go.
Yep. Anything else?
I guess that's all. I'm not trying to attack it.
Okay.
So.
What's dangerous about what you're doing?
I could be trusting an asshole.
You're trusting the spirit of a dead imaginary friend, which could just like be demonic beyond all belief.
It could be the exorcist.
Yeah, that voice always, that voice is always the most evil thing ever, so.
It just, like, flays you alive.
Yeah.
That would be really fascinating. Just don't touch my ears, okay? Don't. They're really, I can hear through all of them.
When he sees your loincloth.
Blueberry Red transports inside of you, and then you just hear, at this moment, new flesh!
But then I get to have a new accent.
Yeah.
Yes.
You start cutting yourself like in Hellraiser 3.
Oh, God.
All right, let's roll that pool.
Yes.
Oh.
2-2.
Look, 2-2.
Dos de dos.
Oh, Mr. Meeseeks.
Oh, he's trying.
Oh, that's awesome.
We're not supposed to live this long.
We're not supposed to live this long.
This is getting kind of weird. Can't do.
Did you get some last month's loot crate?
Yeah.
Oh,
I love that thing.
I'm supposed to do a reduced hit to you, but you're already bashed.
That.
So you're fine. All right. So you do not... You do not immediately take any psychic damage from befriending Blueberry Red, the ghost of General Cortez's imaginary friend.
Which means, General Cortez was murdering his own imaginary friend.
That's why I was like, did we murder or did he murder it?
He murdered it.
He's a fortune teller. I find that in the general.
Yeah.
I don't know.
So
this is the plot to Don't Look Under
Blueberry
the
Red tells you... that.
It's true. I was a real imaginary friend, but then General Cortez had me sacrificed.
Oh, no.
He gave my soul to Queen Starrock. Queen Starrock.
No.
Chief Witch Lord of the Barbarian Lands.
Ah, there we go.
Fweehop.
I'm just imagining like the least creative imaginary friend. It's just a blueberry with arms, and that's it. And it has a red hat on.
Yeah.
Like, it's like General Cortez. Really not
even
great.
No, it's not even a hat. It's just some red painted on its head.
Yeah, just a red streak.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just no, like a.
It's just a cherry that thinks it's a blueberry.
Yeah.
It's in blue face.
Yeah, it's in blue face.
It's a raspberry.
That's not cool.
Yeah, that's basically.
He didn't know what raspberries were.
A red blueberry.
What's that call you?
I've never seen many other people of my kind. They're all dead.
Where can we find
can we
your
blueberry
soul?
Right into every game today? Please no.
Witch Lord.
I don't know, my game's next, so maybe God
did. Go this way.
We should all go this, this way, everybody. Let's go this way. Yes.
And,
yeah, we're all confused what just happened.
And I tell them what who this blueberry red person is.
Oh, okay.
Chief Witch Lord of the Barbarians. And that person is Crane Blembla.
Story checks out.
Crane Starrock.
Starrock, because I can pronounce it. I'm just going to write it down.
All right.
Crane
Starrock. So after some negotiation that needs to happen when you have to explain to Blueberry Red that Blueberry Red can't actually point in a way that you can see, or otherwise,
can
like,
this, can they
indicate
this?
Direction?
No, no.
Can't nod, no. Or like that. Like,
he's just a ball.
Can they say yes, no?
And then you realize just Blueberry Red just sort of starts singing this horrible, kind of sad, keening noise. And it's like,
follow the noise of my soulless song.
I feel like we should pull a tile or something.
Do we all hear this, or is it just in her head?
That's a very
just
good question.
Just slowly driving
you
her mad.
See my face being
you,
like,
you can't figure. You can't. Like, yeah. You just see her like, and you're like, what's happening? And Dash Run Hop Leap goes, let's find out. And he plugs all of you into the
This is hell. I take my own life. Plasma bow.
I just want to see what your like suicide notes.
Blueberry Red needs to be every game.
Today.
Oh my god.
Let's do it.
All right. So you follow the terrible keening noise of the dead ghost child.
Of the dead ghost child blueberry.
And you go into the tunnels underneath the nuclear facility. Mm-hmm. And you follow the long steam tunnels and go through some formerly sealed hatches and whatnot. And then you see that there's this giant pipe that looks like maybe it used to be like some sort of intake pipe for water, but it's got like a giant hole cut into it. And you climb inside the pipe and you walk along the pipe. It takes you a while. It takes you a good probably half an hour, maybe a little bit longer through this dank, dark pipe where everything's echoing as your footsteps echo. And curiously, the keening voice of Blueberry Red also echoes inside the pipe.
Ugh. Oh, so it's super loud.
Just kidding.
And if you had fillings, they would have vibrated out of your mouth at this point. And then suddenly, like it becomes like fainter. And you can see kind of this blur of red light up ahead. And as you look out the end of the pipe, you can see like the swirl of the toxic cloud, like whirling as a hurricane up above you, right? And there are lightning bolts coming down from the cloud, and they're striking down past the entrance of the pipe, several hundred yards beyond it. And as you reach the lip of the pipe, you see that there's this huge crater. and there's this round green crystal.
Is it dark?
It's like oblong. That's oblong. Embedded into this, basically in the bottom of this huge crater. And it looks like it's crashed here, like given the way that the crater has thrown dirt around.
Cool.
You can see like basically like little kind of like spectral spirits swirling around the perimeter of the crater. And the spirits are like, as you gaze closer, you can see that the spirits are vaguely horse-like. And they just seem to kind of like move in a herd around and around the inside of the crater. What do you guys do at this point?
Blueberry Red laughs maniacally.
My blood, you cheering, dude!
You fools! You foolish fools!
Now I'll get my body back! Sacrifice meat? Yay!
Okay. I'm going to take out my Walkman and put on my headphones, which constantly has more music for the Jilted Generation by Prodigy playing.
Oh, man. Was that around 1998?
Yeah, that was 1992, I believe.
Okay.
That was 92 nice. Album. And I'm going to take out my Adam Sling.
You're not going to play Silverchair? What the hell?
No. It doesn't have Smack My Bitch Up, though. That's not that album. Our Firestarter. I'm going to take out my Adam Sling.
No, you guys keep talking.
Okay.
I'm going to get you all. It's
my
Adam
Sling AR9600 smart pad.
Yes.
And start hacking into the actual spirit energy that's wheeling in and out of this crystal.
Wow.
To try and reverse it back into the crystal and pull everything down into it.
Okay.
I'm going to add my Omni scanner along with that too.
All right. Very good.
So I can get a better read of everything. So, boop. But
just taking pictures of ghosts.
Yeah.
It's just orb like right,
right
there.
So you're gonna try and hack into sure
hack the planet.
That's
hack
a,
the planet.
That's a cyber wizard thing.
Mm-hmm.
Definitely. D12.
Anyway, here's Wonderwall. Okay.
That's it. That's all you get.
That's it. D12. Good job.
D12. Yeah.
You get a bonus for using your smart pad. So that's a D10.
I'm going to use a... Now, does this crystal look, like, damaged at all? Like, it's been, like, cracked open?
Yeah. So there are definitely fractures in the crystal from the impact. It's, you know, the bottom of it, it looks like a giant crystal spike with a rounded top that's embedded into the bottom of the crater.
Oh, it's like the meteorite in Super Mario Brothers movie. Okay.
No.
Which, by the way, is available to watch in full on YouTube.
Yep.
Because
no one's taking it down.
It's taking it down.
Do the high five with me that they do. Click, 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 click. They do the... Okay.
I'm sorry.
I'm gonna
it's
use,
been too long
I'm going to use
I've
We Can
it.
Rebuild It, to add a plus one to it and try to... reassemble it.
Okay.
Try and find out the exact.
Did you pay the PowerPoint for that?
Yeah.
Movie.
Okay.
Solid.
All right. So
pretty happy with
that's
the,
an extra what?
The plot. It's not at all
that
depressing,
just adds,
but that's
right?
One of Bob Hoskins' last movies.
Yeah, that just adds a plus
in
one.
No way
to
is that depressing.
No. Well, I mean, Raul Julia did Street Fighter. So.
Yeah. Normally you'd use that during
Street
like the
battle
that
that's
we used.
Yeah. Oh well.
To refresh additional damage.
I'm having trouble keeping any of this going.
So. That's what I'm doing. Now, bad stuff that can happen.
Look behind the curtain. It's awful.
The horses could hack you back.
Yeah, the horses. I could release a swarm of cyber ghosts.
That would be a stampede.
Oh, no, the Apaches.
Do you think this Crystal Castle runs Linux?
Probably.
At least CentOS.
So the horses, the ghost horses, could rebel.
You could alert someone to your presence.
Mm-hmm. I could also be overwhelmed by the toxic lightning storm this happened.
Yeah, the lightning could feed back into your system.
Uh-huh.
Again.
All right. Roll that pool.
Hey. That's not too bad.
Four successes,
one failure.
Yep.
Nice.
Okay, so one failure is no big deal. Check up one box on your danger meter. Four successes. All right. So
my smart pad screen reflects on my face, like in Hackers, because that's how computers work.
Yeah.
The glow reflects onto your face.
You can see everything you're typing.
Yep.
Right. Okay.
Code.
So. You are cyber wizarding, and you are cyber wizarding the hardest you can cyber wizard. First off, first bit of information that pulls up on your AR
smart pad, AR 96,
AR 9600 smart pad, is
I got you, Pip Boy.
Is that these creatures are 100% spectral energy. They are not in any way, shape, or form actually physical.
Okay.
They exist purely as ethereal ghosts. However, you are able to use the ambient electricity that's
zapping down into it.
Zapping the main crystal spike, as we may want to call it. And also use this pipe as an antenna. And you can actually send like a sounding signal into the crystal, and you can tell that it is a hollow structure that appears to be some sort of vessel, and you can definitely detect heat signatures inside. And they are humanoid. You can also pinpoint an entrance if you so... or what you think is an entrance.
Okay.
And there's some very large mass.
Lord Parlor Zuko.
Inside that's like probably a couple of tons.
Worth inside of the crystal?
Of mass inside of the crystal. Yeah, well, I mean, this thing is like 120 feet in diameter. Like, it's not tiny. And this thing seems to have like a very slow heartbeat.
So it's a space coffin on top of an ancient Indian burial ground.
Stab it in the heart.
Yeah.
And it's surrounded by spectral horses in a lightning hurricane?
Yeah. That's a yes.
What is blueberry red?
I'm going to punch
this. This is actually this is going to be easy for me to figure out.
I relay all of that.
Okay. Well, I mean, basically, all you have to do is turn around and show everybody. You're like, then there's.
That's actually the best.
Check this biz out.
That's actually the best thing you could have told me, because I can combine a couple things to just to really work this out.
Uh-huh. So I just take my pad. I just go, fuck it, and drop it on the ground and throw my hands in the air.
Okay, so
out of my comfort zone.
So this is actually something that my character has been talking about for a while.
Wow. What's going on about these ghost horses?
Yeah. Okay. So my character's been talking to you guys about ghost horses and hurricanes for a while, and just basically the general gist of it is they do not exist, in my opinion. These things are figments of our imagination, and really all it is we only see these things because our brains just haven't turned off the filter for these things. So I have neural pulse darts that are normally used offensively to shut a person's brain down.
I love how your MO is basically, I'm going to attack the other rest of the players.
But I'm going to explode myself. You're doing the Freddy Krueger approach.
So we have these neural pulse darts.
You have no power over
that,
me.
So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the neural pulse darts to shut off that filter part of our brains. So you'll just get a short little electrical shock into your brain for a moment as this dart hits your temple.
I like how you don't clear this with anyone either.
Guys,
I got this.
You're just like, I got it.
So it's just...
No, here's something cool, guys. You're just going to get a short electrical shock into your brain.
Yep.
That's perfectly normal, perfectly safe.
It's not going to take but a second. And then
get tasered in the face.
Yeah, I knew this would happen because, like I said, I've been talking about ghost horses and hurricanes.
I knew
for a
this
while.
Thing I don't believe in would happen eventually.
Right. Thank God I prepared for
that's
that.
That's like an
situation.
Atheist. It's like, oh, I knew this rapture would come.
Yeah,
I'll hold all of you.
I'm soaked yeah, and out of my garments tonight.
I was ready to be able to disable this out of our brains with the neural pole starts. And I'm just going to go ahead and dive in with my sand goggles and Omni scanner, because once I've hit myself and everybody else with a pole start, we're all going to be good to go
just
in.
Just keep going in
so
my
I
head.
So I'm just going to dive into the center of the storm, basically, with all of this happening.
Bye.
I'm going to shock all of you in the brain, yeah. And then I'm going to dive
myself.
Directly into the center of the toxic.
Why do you keep including us in, like, your weird death wishes?
Well, hold on, you must witness this as
if
well.
If I'm going out, you're going to see it and feel all that sadness.
Well, the thing is,
you guys will be sorry.
I'm doing it. The thing is, I'm doing it to protect you guys. Like, this is all for
you'll be alive, but it won't really be living after I do this.
Gaze into the void of my soul.
How was your day? Bad. I saw a guy jump into a toxic hurricane.
And then,
I felt all of it.
And then just. If anybody is if anybody wants to join me, you can. But
yeah,
I'll be
good.
Okay.
And so are you diving towards the crystal? You're diving into the storm.
Well, the crystal's like underneath the storm, like down below, or
yeah, it's underneath. So this pipe like comes out into this huge crater.
Yeah.
And the storm is swirling above you.
Yeah.
And then kind of like sticking out at a awkward jagged angle.
I'm diving down into the crystal. I mean, basically what I'm doing with the neural pole starts is disabling and removing the horses and the hurricane from our brains are seeing something that
just
isn't
an
there.
Illusion.
It
doesn't even
illusion.
Actually exist.
Yeah, it's since well, the neural pole starts allow us to roll the disbelief.
Guys, wow. If you don't believe them, they don't just trample to death under goat horses.
All right, so I'm going to start
it's
with...
It's not really happening.
This is a cyber wizard really thing.
Oh, is it really?
Because you're trying to persuade others with your logical thinking.
Oh, boy, that's not good, because that's a D4 for me.
Yeah. But you get a D10 for using your... I knew this would happen.
Okay. Okay.
And we're using a piece of your neural darts as a D8.
You all laughed at me for buying all that canned meat. Now look who's...
right?
Now, what else? Anything else? Any other pieces of equipment?
It was just... Oh, Omni scanner?
I don't know. Were you using that?
Well, the Omni scanner with the sand goggles. Basically, just because as I jump in, I need to actually be able to, like, figure out what this crystal
is.
Sure,
so that's an additional D6.
Are any of these traits?
Yeah, the D4 Cyber Wizard is your trait.
Oh boy, that's not good because I got to roll that one twice now.
These horses could be very real.
What's dangerous about what
that they could be real?
Dash Run Hop Leap is about to attempt.
Just because you don't believe in it doesn't mean it doesn't exist.
No. I taxes it the same way.
Oh man. I really should believe in this, but I don't.
So it might not be an illusion.
Yeah.
That's number one.
Right, that is
that's
true.
That's crushed big, to death.
Yeah. Is there anything else that we might want to incorporate into the danger component of this?
Could be trampled by, well, I guess that goes along with
struck by lightning.
I feel like that falls under might not be an illusion.
I'm interacting with the crystal.
Yeah, scanning the crystal could
alert.
Yeah,
it could trigger something. Yeah. Sure. Yeah. All right, let's roll it.
Oh, wow.
Oh.
That's not bad. Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 successes and 2 failures.
Yeah.
That's surprisingly
holy
good.
Holy balls. Mark yourself up 2 danger.
Yep.
And then I believe you take a stunned hit. Am I wrong? Or you take a reduced hit?
A reduced hit?
So
okay.
Normally you'd be injured, but you're stunned instead.
Okay.
So you now have to roll.
And I got a lightning bolt too.
You now have to roll 5s instead of 4s in order to succeed.
Because I'm stunned.
Because you're stunned.
Got it.
Yeah. However, like, so he hits you with these neural darts, and you're like, ah!
Why? He'll just fall on the ground.
And from the neural dart, and then he stabs one into his head, and the lightning bolts all shoot out and connect all of your darts together again.
You're like the Riddler in Batman Forever.
and then you're like, well, I know how this goes. Yeah. And he immediately dives headfirst into the storm and toward the crystal.
We're all just lying on the ground screaming up into the air.
He hits the side of the crystal with his forehead, but just before impact, he flings his magnet reel out. Zzz! Bong! Knocks himself unconscious. Your world turns to stars.
Yep.
When it clears, you see the magna grapple reeling back in. He is dish ragged, just like, and yet somehow when it comes to the lip of the pipe, whoop, perfect 2-point landing.
I love how we all just like, we're like, all right, this is his plan like usual. He's injured his head multiple times. And none of us are like, maybe stop doing this. Yep. Like,
at least wear a helmet.
Yeah. But when the stars finally clear and you look outside.
Yeah, years from now, there's going to be an investigation into why you guys let me continue hurting my head like this.
You knew he wasn't right. Why did you keep letting him?
Yeah.
Because it's entertaining. Yeah. Yep. But no other.
I give him a cortisone shot. He's good.
Yep. Get back out there.
when the sparkling stars that swarmed over your eyes finally clear, you can see that there is no horses.
He's always right, there, too. Like, that's the most insane thing.
There is no storm above you. There is clear blue sky. And hear like a faint kind of like chirping of birds. And for a minute there, you're like, oh, that sounds pleasant. Until several of them just start going, gah, gah, gah!
Oh, God.
The crystal spike is still embedded firmly in the center of the crater.
I told you guys ghost horses and hurricanes weren't real. I've been saying it for years.
And you proved us all wrong with your head. Yep. Literally. Thank you.
I told all you, and you just walk away with your ears bleeding. I'm going to prescribe you a walk it off.
You said I'd get a concussion. Well, yes. But.
You're going to be like Jim McMahon from the Bears. just years later.
All right. What would you like to do at this point? It looks like the way forward to the spike is clear.
I want to construct a helmet to keep him from tapping into my brain. Like a Magneto helmet.
Like a reverse Magneto helmet.
Don't you have like...
I have Cyber Wizard. I can use Cyber Gadget as a beta.
Yes, you can use... So your Cyber Gadget's alpha and beta are two things that are handy pieces of equipment you just decide you have.
Okay.
But they're temporary one-use things, so it will protect you from the next time he tries to link lines with you. But it can't. He would probably burn it out after that.
Yeah. It looks like a Nintendo system that's been hollowed out to form a helmet, and has a like sensor, like a energy scanner over my left eye.
Nice. All right.
You can tell power levels.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then you have the Wii.
Oh, 9,000!
Sorry.
And the visor is just a Wii U pad that shows your eyes.
It's just a Virtual Boy cut out duct taped to my head.
Yeah, technically, the Wii U had not been invented in 1998.
Is the top a laser tag helmet?
Yeah, the top is the laser tag helmet. Like,
this is the foam helmet.
Basically. So,
we don't know. We're like, where do we go from there?
I know.
However, you do see the crystal spike begin to vibrate. Yeah. And you hear this droning, and then there's and all the birds like suddenly take off.
Birds are real, by the way. Just so you guys know.
That's my I don't believe in birds. That's my thing.
Just FYI.
Birds are real.
Guys, come on. Birds are real.
Yeah. I've been saying it for years. Birds are real.
Birds are real.
All right. So you there's this horrible vibration that's coming off the crystal, and you can see with your fancy new enhanced senses helmet that it's vibrating in a weird like counterpoint to the heartbeat. And there's cracks kind of forming along that.
God.
That's creepy.
Along
guys, it looks
are
like
we missing a shard? Is it like dark crystal? Were you going to stick it back in or something? It
smells like gifling.
I don't know. I don't know. Maybe you should have searched the throne for shards. Where
there's over 9,000.
Two secret compartments. There's probably three.
Yep, good point.
Why you bug out?
Well, shit.
Well, we have an inquisitor. Why doesn't our inquisitor find out why the vibration is crystalline?
Yeah, why is the vibration crystalline?
Are you okay?
Yes.
Yeah, what?
Can't sit like that?
Nope.
How is Xenu responsible for this?
Yeah. How can we really make Xenu responsible for this?
I gotta say, it really feels like you're trying to sit like a human really hard right now.
I am.
Just checking. Like, this is how human beings sit,
people
right?
People sit like this.
You're like an alien
that's mocking the way people sit.
This is what you things do, right?
Who wants pizza food?
I love basket sports.
Pizza food. Okay. Are you guys taking any action at this point?
I wanna go back into the great history of Gar. Uh-huh. And see if there's a precursor to this crystal shard that might enlighten me as to what happened here. How did this fall and then create this illusion of stampeding spectral horses for no reason?
So you can sell t-shirts. Just,
yeah. and see what might be housed within. We know that there's still some sort of beating force within there, right? But yeah. But beyond that, I don't know. So yeah.
Okay. So give me. So Inquisitor is what you are. So that's a D12. Yep. Yes.
Uh-huh.
And didn't you say you're using the Great Book of Gar?
Yeah.
Uh-huh. So it's a D10.
Okay.
All right.
And what the hell? I'll throw my Omni Scanner in there too.
Okay.
I like the idea that this is some kind of roadside attraction, like by Mason's thinking. And some farmer just comes out.
Okay.
Don't shred off these t-shirts.
You horses. What's dangerous about this? The Great Book of Gar could be completely wrong on this particular account.
Completely shake your foundation. Just,
it's again disturbing the crystal.
Yeah, it's just interacting with this incredibly powerful crystal, which is about to explode.
Who does not believe me?
Sure.
Blasphemy!
You reinvoke the horses.
That sounds great.
All right,
let's roll it.
Let's do
Gar
it.
Believes in ghost horses.
Ah, damn it!
Oh, dang!
Oh,
well, that's five successes.
Yeah,
five
that's successes. All
five successes. Five dice.
That's all successes. All
the crystal disintegrates.
It opens itself onto you.
Okay. So
the Book of Gar is completely wrong, but
so. You're like, this sounds familiar. And then sure enough, boom, there's this whole chapter.
Fuiha.
It's just the word Fuiha.
However, it is illustrated.
Okay, yeah.
And you see a picture of a great green crystal spike traveling through space. Striking it for the planet, leaving this huge boulder, crater behind. It cracks, which is like, oh, okay, that's like, a little bit what we didn't know, but like B and C, great, like step two and three, we are watching this, that's fine. And then D is it cracks open, and this huge demonic creature with horns and dripping fangs, wielding. A scythe.
Nice.
Erupts from inside of the thing, and he has a trio of
I missed that one.
A trio of witches around him, he walks forth on the earth, inflicting slavery and devastation.
You know what that thing's name is? Blueberry Red.
We're in the illustration too. Like all of us drawn exactly how we look because it was so successful.
There's this little pipe, and its first act you can see that it just like casts like this ray of necrotic energy, and then there's like just five little puffs,
yeah.
And then on to the next frame.
Fuiha. Okay.
What is it?
Fuiha?
Well, and all of a sudden
I still don't get it.
It is I, Fweeha the Destroyer!
Fweeha! Fweeha's afraid to leave his Fweeha. Fweeha's afraid to leave his Fweeha.
All right, so, Fweeha.
What did you do? I just start shaking you by your lapel.
He summoned it.
Yeah. What did you do, Fweeha? Fwee!
All right, so Fweehawk the Destroyer is on the board. It turns out that the three witches are named Crane, Stay, Rock.
Rock's the cool one.
Yeah.
Rock.
Rock skateboards out of the crystal.
Got a mohawk.
Sup, nerds.
Got a power glove on.
Flicks out.
And all
flicks
of a sudden you see him spin around and then like freezes in place and big in big golden letters it says 360 stale fish.
Throws three snap wristlets on simultaneously.
Whoa! Yeah.
Every movement has a whip to it.
Yes.
All right, so.
Well, Crane must be the sensitive one then.
What would you say?
It stays the simple one.
Yep.
Stay. All right. Stay. Let's take action, everybody. Who would like to go first?
Do we really know they mean harm? I mean, even though he seems a little aggravated, he could just be irritated because this one.
Fweeha, the Destroyer.
Maybe he's a destroyer.
Not named for being nice.
Maybe he destroys butt fish shields.
I'm going to flick out some reflective shades, throw them on, tighten my power glove.
Nice.
Make sure to put on your bandana.
Yeah. And give a nice let's party. And then slam the ground with my hand to summon nanite swarm.
Oh shit, look
to try and engulf the witches. Because I assume they're all standing together. Kind of like this.
They're actually they're swirling around him. They're rotating around him.
And I'm gonna
to fly of their own volition.
I'm gonna go for Fweeha then.
Yeah. Okay. You're gonna have to get through the witches to get to Fweeha. That's the thing. They're sort of circling him as guardians.
Is he still standing in the crystal?
He's standing atop it. Yes. So I should point
so
that out.
So could that
like
possibly,
he's kind of like emerged from
his
it?
Power source or something?
Possibly be a power source. I mean, he's been sitting in it for however long.
1 billion years.
Yeah, like 1 billion years. Just use it to eat away at all of the crystal. Yeah, I'm gonna target his crystal.
Okay. All right.
Oh. And then he just turns into a puddle of water.
Real quick. Can I get Starbucks orders? Not from chat, but just from.
Yeah, we'll text him to you.
Yeah, chat. I guess we forgot to tell you guys. We are literally buying everyone on the internet Starbucks.
Jack-O-Boom, what do you want?
Yeah, Jack-O-Boom. Mama 963.
Keep it like under $5.
Yeah, let's not be greedy, guys.
Come on,
let's
go cool,
like venti cool. Frappuccino, yeah. Whatever.
Flat white.
Blue Water Baron, you're not getting shit.
What?
He's getting all the stuff from me. No.
What?
Yeah.
What do they have on the secret?
That's a
menu?
Thing. I promise.
Make me a mint chocolate chip frappe. Okay, hold on.
French vanilla something.
Yeah, black coffee with. Yeah, black coffee.
Black coffee.
Am I gonna have
Pike's Place, huh?
There you go. Latte, yeah. Thanks.
Put me to sleep.
No, you can't get a cake pop, Lord Boo.
What?
Oh God,
cake
we just said you know just keep like it simple. God. We're getting.
And there's like three
coffee.
Types of
if
cake.
If you're
pops.
Getting anything, you're getting a slice of lemon loaf. Yeah. And you'll be happy. About
you're
it.
Gonna be happy with those 420 calories.
Yeah, and then we're gonna have to get another text because it's like, hey, they said they're out. Do you want the?
Yeah.
Like, oh God, come on.
And it's like, and it's the start. It's like 7 a.m. It's like, how are you out of lemon loaf already? Like,
yeah.
The day's just starting.
And there's just like 15 people behind
Venti
you.
Camel,
you
don't know.
You're going back and forth with him.
Coconut milk. Ugh, what are
Jesus.
We
now? You're just being difficult.
Are we in communist China? What is this?
Oh my God! You know, I used to think America
you know what,
was in
getting,
a good
you're
place.
You're getting an oatmeal bar,
but
that's
now,
what you're getting because it's garbage.
Something small and sweet, caramel something.
Caramel something.
Wrap.
Caramel wrap.
Yeah.
Caramel
small
wrap.
Caramel.
Yeah. I
oh
might,
boy!
This might be alcohol to me.
I don't even know what that means.
Like.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Venti caramel like, ribbon crunch. So they just have that, candy on top of it.
That that whole that house. That line right there, venti caramel ribbon crunch with coconut milk.
Tall mocha frat.
Yeah, see that's fine. White great, I get it. I get where that's coming from.
Castles and Chemo.
But Neo Storm X, you literally that sentence is what's wrong with America.
Tall, small.
Grande, please.
He's like 5 miles from us. We can go kick his ass right now.
Yeah.
Oh, really?
You know what? Here's the thing. We don't need
Here
to.
Here I come.
We don't need to, because with an order like that, ISIS
gonna
will.
Gonna get in the fuck wagon and come kick
ISIS
your ass.
Wins because of you, Neo. ISIS wins.
Amanda, would you like
today in news, ISIS made its first terrorist attack in Valencia, California.
It's like 24 is coming to life, you guys. Yeah,
they heard about the ridiculous things at Starbucks, Tyler, and they were like, all right, we need to reprioritize our terrorist attacks.
What's in a pumpkin
spice latte?
Not pumpkins.
Not a pumpkin.
Whoa.
Watermelon.
Carcinogens.
Here's what I know. I'm a big fan of pumpkin spice, just so everybody knows.
What's up?
I'm the biggest basic bitch around.
Oh, it's delicious, though.
Pumpkin spice is amazing.
It's so good.
What is a basic bitch?
You don't know what a basic bitch is?
Basic bitches?
I don't know what a basic bitch is.
Wow. I mean.
Actually, I don't think that's basic at all.
How big is your Pinterest board? Yeah.
I don't know. All right. Have we selected?
Yes. Okay.
Yeah. All right.
There's a Fweeha the Destroyer.
All right. You're attacking
like
the crystal.
The researcher.
Yeah. So that's a cyber wizard move.
Is trying to destroy the crystal first.
You said you're slamming your fist against the ground.
I'm like a palm.
Like
and then just spread out to send a wave of nanites.
Oh, that's right. You're summoning the nanites for me. Yeah, that's a cyber wizard move. No question.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I'm not just gonna. I just punch the ground and be like, let's do this.
Yeah. That was dumb.
Break my hand.
The ground is just. I feel like you can do that, like dubstep.
Oh no.
From you.
Oh no.
I mean, just even I would have disabled your brain first before doing that.
Disable your brain before doing
that. That's courtesy at the very least.
Well, whatever.
I need ice. Okay. Yeah.
Things are gonna be easier.
Dance off, bro.
Ooh, child.
Yeah.
So yeah, nanite swarm.
Can we all start holding hands and then?
All right, so you're gonna spend the power token to do that.
Yep. Don't worry, my turn isn't up yet. I will connect us through our brains. We don't need to hold hands.
Gamora.
And then
Orko.
All right, so D12 and a D10.
What does she run?
Are you gonna? Are you gonna invoke any of your Missandei powers?
Yeah, I'll do.
I'll
do Raging Fury, 1,000 Flame Wars.
Okay.
Oh, I'm totally
you have to spend
that.
A power token to activate that too.
Cow.
So we're thank you. So okay. Flame Wars. You so you probably all you have cow. To do is basically just hashtag.
Yeah. Hashtag yes all.
Which gender is not a binary?
Okay, so that gives you a D8. What's dangerous about what you're doing?
Gamer nerds.
Yeah, he's
provoke Gamergate.
Yeah, he's provoking Gamergate.
Make him fuck off.
That's got to be at least one D6. Yes. If not, it's either one.
I tore down one of those posters at E3.
It's either one D6 or
I was down there and I ripped it down off.
It's either one D6 or 8 billion egg avatars. I'm not sure which.
Oh God.
Your opinion is valid.
Crushed under the weight of egg avatars.
So you get a D6 because somebody's gonna hashtag you false flag. You get a D6 because maybe the crystal's energy has been drained. It doesn't do a damn
maybe.
Thing.
Yeah.
What if when you hit the ground, it also just evaporates underneath you? Like nanite swarm, but the floor beneath you goes too.
The floor doesn't exist now.
Well, yeah, like you're using
everything's
it.
Fake here!
Well, you're using it to attack. So
like as
you
you're about
down.
To hit the ground, I'm like, I forgot to tell you, craters aren't real.
Oh, shit! God damn it!
It's just a hole!
I just fall into blackness. Get out of my head!
It's like Daryl Strawberry.
Or what if the power? What if the crystal Ozzie does Smith. Have power, and it short circuits everything?
Ooh. Yeah, and it comes back on him.
The crystal has power, and it turns the nanites against you.
Yeah.
Boom! Roll it. Let's do it.
It's like the Borg.
Let's dance.
Oh.
That was the best ever. Uh-huh.
Pretty good.
You've done ever.
You're the best.
Around.
No one's ever gonna keep you down.
Four successes, two failures.
Four successes, two failures.
Which
so
one's failed?
Mark yourself
so I feel
up
like before playing D6s. This game, we should watch Kung Fury.
No. All right, yeah, so you did. Take 1 point of basher damage.
Okay.
You know what? Honestly, I'm done with it. You guys are too.
Yeah. Yeah.
I've had my fill.
So yeah, you just you. You
also, it doesn't exist.
You throw your power glove to the floor and you just reach up to the you know, face up to the sky and say, I summon the power of 8chan! And there's just like.
Yep.
And you can see just red cracks forming in the ground.
Yep.
and just this entire army of nanites come forth. And yet they have kind of like a decidedly like clear, liquidy texture to them, as if it was maybe millions upon millions of male tears that had been locked away in a vault underground for ages.
I drink them.
Nice. Gain sustenance.
Yes, so for
remove some
hits,
danger dice.
They surround the crystal sphere and then instantly vaporize into this electric steam that does a hit to each of the witches and a hit to Fuiha the Destroyer himself.
That's really good. Yes. Solid Snake shows up so and talks to us about nanomachines.
There's just this like there's this feedback loop of like of disingenuous logic, straw man attacks, and everybody creating alternate egg accounts to back up something that's ridiculous that somebody right. else said. Nobody using their real name except for Fuiha the Destroyer.
Yeah.
All right.
And that's why he's gonna lose the argument.
And they're shocked. All right. Speaking of Fuiha, Fuiha Prime, what would you like to do?
Yeah, well, I am, you
Daddy!
Know,
is Fuiha Prime?
Yeah, I feel like he's yeah. not Prime. Yeah, this has got to be Prime.
Fuiha the Prime
Fuiha looks at everyone is just like, be gone! And he speaks English
Don't
for the first time.
Don't let it become your alpha.
Do
you even Fuiha?
I just stare at him, and I'm just like, Fuiha! Fuiha! Fuiha!
Does that mean you're related? Yeah. Is that what he's
mom
saying?
Moment.
Fuiha?
Is that your grandfather?
Fuiha.
Your great-great-grandfather.
Fuiha, just Fuiha. Scolding him.
Yeah, I'm literally just...
Me and mother are very disappointed in you, young man.
I am just, like, railing into him
you
with this.
You snuck out after your curfew.
Son.
And
he's your son, but also your grandfather.
As I
have a very different... They have a strange view of family there.
I'm talking and moving towards him, and I'm just...
Are you
just
going for
like,
to get a confession?
Yeah, well, yeah.
It's an auditing session.
Resist evil with your indomitable will.
Yes. I'm resisting evil with my indomitable will, exactly.
Okay.
Yep.
And so I'm just moving towards him and just giving him a talking to.
You're being a real suppressive person right now.
Yeah, as I'm doing it, I just keep walking and I whip out my plasma bow and without looking, I just shoot the witches with the plasma bow and I'm still talking to Fuiha the Destroyer and I'm just like, ugh. So I'm just going to shoot. I'm just going to shoot them. So,
and I'm done with you, young man.
Okay.
Yeah.
Come back here.
Well, all right.
You
so
keep running, you're gonna make it worse.
If you're gonna shoot, if your main thing is shooting them,
he's a. What's that thing?
I feel like your main thing is trying to cow.
Yeah, I'm focusing on Fuiha. I'm trying to.
All right, so that's your maybe? Inquisitor of Gar. That's your yeah. D12 for that.
Yeah,
sure. And you're using your plasma bow to help intimidate.
Yes.
Uh huh. So that's a D10.
D10.
Are you going to activate any powers, or are you out of
I
power tokens?
I'm out.
How do we? Do we? Can we like restore these?
Anytime that you cross one of the little lightning bolts on your danger meter.
Yep, that's why you got to do crazy shit like me.
Hey, wait.
That's why you just got to launch yourself into whatever storm is happening.
Right. I'm just trying to figure out what's dangerous here.
Part of my toolkit is maybe a little bit of like a. Something that kind of makes me look the way that I look to all of them, but it's actually more of like an illusion, and I look more like Fuiha the Destroyer.
Yeah, There are two dogs in a trench coat.
So you're gonna deactivate.
I'm
part
gonna
of
deactivate
your,
my tool my toolkit that makes me look like this,
and it reveals you as the demon.
Holy shit! I throw up.
What? It's trying to out of fear. You don't want it on your gear.
It's just disgusting. It's just disgusting.
You get an swallow additional it. D6 for that.
Okay. As soon as you take down your disguise, I just electrocute myself.
Why didn't I see this all along?
No, I go back to seeing you like normal now. Yeah. I just electrocute myself and like, oh no, he's fine.
All right. So,
okay, so that's that. So what's dangerous about this?
The witches could get you. That's one.
What do you mean, what's dangerous about this?
Yeah, there's nothing. Come on.
Fuiha the Destroyer could just outright, like, over-command your attempts to command him.
Yeah.
Yeah, he can try.
And there's a prophecy to him, so could happen.
Yeah.
He has a little weight.
And, I don't know that there's anything else that your comrades could turn on you because you just revealed yourself as a horrible demon creature.
That's two Fuiha.
Right. Yeah, a horrifying nether realm creature.
And we could totally get you two confused.
Good.
Yeah.
We don't look alike.
Tell me something.
You all look alike.
You people
look alike.
You know.
And that's
you
not people. Racist.
You know each other.
That is racist. Yeah. But you do look alike.
Yeah.
Here's also
going to
be my rule.
You're both two Fuiha.
At this point, now that you've dropped your demonic disguise, you can speak full sentences.
Yeah. Oh, good. Listen, good. Because I was about Fuiha, to have
Fuiha,
you.
Fuiha, Fuiha, Fuiha.
Say something only Fuihas would say.
Fuiha?
Okay, I'm sold.
Story checks out. Yeah.
All right,
let's roll it.
Something about it, I believe him.
Very red.
Oh boy.
Oh.
You should have stayed as Fuiha. Yeah.
Okay, I'm gonna regret. I'm
I
gonna regret this.
Fuiha explodes.
I'm gonna regret this, but I'm gonna use telepathic. So I'm connected to the web of thoughts and emotions going on all around. You can allow an ally to reroll the failed danger dice and roll by saying how your telepathic powers assist them. I'm not letting you use your reroll. Raise your danger meter by one for each reroll die. How many is that?
Four.
So one. It says times two. So
yeah.
Okay.
No, it's just one.
Okay. Three, four. So I get two tokens for those rerolls. And so how this works is. So I'm going to assist you in the reroll. So I'm actually I'm just gonna grab my force axe and right as you're about to do the thing you're doing, I'm like envisioning. I'm like, oh shit, he's about to do this wrong, and so I connect with you and everyone else in the party.
Nope.
He's so got a cyber helmet on. Yeah.
But you know what? I'm gonna get you with the next one.
You're just crab walking like this.
I don't feel nothing.
So you don't feel it, but everybody else connects to this, and I just take my force axe and I literally just. Take a chunk out of my arm.
Oh, what the hell?
So you feel this and are obviously distracted by it.
You're so lucky you have a trust fund.
I know. Honestly, it's a great situation for me.
So
it distracts you just enough so you're not able to actually roll the original failed one, and you get a second chance to do it correctly this time.
And
you guys all unfortunately have to feel you for the first time. You actually get the full extent of the madness in Fuiha's head, and also the pain of the force axe chopping.
So
in my
you
arm.
Go, ah!
What was he doing again?
Oh yeah, yeah.
Which one pierces more, the pain of the force axe or the pain in your heart?
I'll let you guys decide.
Yeah, probably the force axe.
Yeah,
the force shots alone.
Oh, one better.
One better. Three and three.
Three and three.
So we all feel that.
Yeah, you all feel that.
This
all
doesn't feel worth it at all.
No. Here's the thing, it was totally worth it. I got two tokens.
You're just spraying blood everywhere.
Yeah, right? Yeah.
You're welcome!
You're like welcome.
Kill Bill
style. Why is he our leader, kind of?
On everybody. Make it rain.
Yeah, I'm making it rain, guys.
What's up, man? Your character is basically like the one like shameful son in like a rich family.
Yeah.
Like, you're the oft-talked-about Kennedy son.
Yeah, oh, yeah, yeah. I'm the one who's constantly getting in trouble.
So,
the least favorite Baldwin.
Yeah.
Oh, for sure.
You, Steven.
Which is the one nobody talks about, actually.
You do... Yeah. Okay, so you are scolding Fuiha the Destroyer. You are trying to bully and badger him into not taking these actions which have been foretold in the Book of Fuiha. and for a moment, he stands and just looks at you confused. And is like, Fuiha? And then he like thinks for just a scant moment. You see like a moment of contemplation, and then he's like, "Fuiha!" And he turns and he points, and a lightning bolt shoots from his hand and cracks more of the crystal spire away. And this huge section cracks open and is exposed to the beckoning heart of Fuiha, and it mesmerizes you. It's just like, boom, 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 boom. And you're like, ah. And it's got like these huge, like, you know, like veins and arteries coming out of it, and they're like alternately like sucking in like life force from the planet, and then like you can see like a little like negative energy, like, you know, little demon spirit destroyers coming out.
Wow.
Yeah, that's pretty gross.
All right.
Yes.
I'm.
Oh man, can you resurrect those pandas?
He's an immortal god, so he probably.
I'm going to fall on my dark bargain.
Stupid fucking name again.
And summon forth the black mist of Balathama. To penetrate and take over the heart of Fuiha. And bend it to my will.
Oh wow.
With electric whip. Yes.
Boy.
These are for you.
Ooh, yeah, all right. So you're spending some points here to try and use your sorcerous bargain to actually bend the dark heart of Fuihas.
And the black mist of Balahalhas.
The black mist of Balathamas, yes.
Exactly.
What's going on?
What's the story?
What an expanding one, too.
Well, oh, boy. Ender of Man.
Strap here's in. The thing. I'm going to give you your choice of either...
Tyler,
Inquisitor
Ender of Man
to use your indomitable will, or Ninja to use your network of contacts to get something you need.
What was the first one?
Inquisitor.
Going to go Inquisitor.
Okay.
My indomitable will.
Yes. Shmoo.
Oh, God. Oh, so boy. Perfect in a sad way.
Yeah.
All right, so whatever that is, plus a D10, plus a D8. All right.
I don't even know how to answer that question, really. Yeah. What's going on? What's the story?
No, yeah, we're at the very end of the session here. Sorry.
Oh, good. So we'll get a chance to recap.
Yeah. So three dice of danger, I think, is well established if you try to mess with this thing.
I'm going to mess with the heart.
Either the witches, the heart, or the Fuiha will get you.
Going for the heart.
Anything else?
I think that's good.
Oh! It couldn't get any worse.
I have a question real quick. How many dice would that be?
Six.
Six. One, two,
no,
three,
he would
four,
re-roll.
Five.
He would re-roll
five. Oh, five. I'm sorry. Yeah. Two, three, four. Oh, if I go God. This far into the danger zone. Danger zone. If I go this far, would that vanquish me? What does that do?
No, what that means
turn
is
turn into dust.
Well, two things.
You would be one. Mad. Oh shit!
You get to use three trait dice when taking an action,
right?
As opposed to just
wow,
one.
Wow, never.
I actually says times five trait dice for vanquish.
You're right. I'm sorry. For you, it's times five. So you can use five trait dice along with any equipment and power bonuses.
Right.
And then secondly, if you were to take a full hit. You would be vanquished.
Yeah, I'd be dead.
Yeah, you'd be dead. If you take a reduced hit, you would be knocked out.
Okay. So, but who cares?
I like that logic. So I'm rerolling those five.
Who cares? YOLO.
Dash run. Dash run becomes part of the speed force.
Take my YOLO. Two more coins.
It becomes part of the speed force.
Just waste all of those.
Oh, I'm gonna use them all on my next action.
Yeah.
Because I'm going out in a blaze of glory in my next action.
The hop leap motto on their coat of arms is just who cares.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm amazed I made it this long.
Right.
And you have that tattooed all down.
Yeah, yeah. I actually I have the tattoo right here. I've got the chest tattoo, and it just says nihilism.
Yeah. And hypothetical bulge.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
On like the top Russian it says, tattoos. Your brain, are you using that? And at the bottom it says, who cares?
Yep. Yeah. And actually, I have on my inner thighs, I have hashtag YOLO. And it's not the hashtag sign, it's the word hashtag.
YOLO. Hashtag on one leg and YOLO on the other?
Yeah.
All right.
So re-roll
your fails.
Yep.
I really hope it hits more ones again. I'm sorry.
Right?
It'd be so funny.
Did you pick them all up or just the?
No, just the.
That's significantly better.
That's yeah. Well, that's definitely. Yeah. That's a lot better.
Two fails.
Two fails.
But
all right.
Four successes.
So you take a reduced hit. Where are you at with your danger track, danger meter?
I am barely entering stunned.
Yeah.
Unlike these guys.
You're barely into stunned.
I'm entering stunned now. If I take two.
Yeah, you take two. So you go into stunned. So that means you take a point of bashed.
Oh no.
Because you take a reduced hit.
You guys have not.
And then how many successes?
Four.
Four successes. Yep. All right. Well, it turns out that is enough to mitigate the beckoning heart of Fuiha the Destroyer.
Not Fuiha.
So you now have like bound this in the mists of Balthamas, mm-hmm. and you hear Balthamas's voice in your head say, "Yes, my son, I hunger. Open the gate."
Amazing.
I open it.
Yeah, of course.
I open it.
Yeah, oh, no, the dogs are out.
Oh, you got it.
All right, so you basically say, you know, as you command.
As you
guys,
command.
You guys can hear just like a rumbling just begin to happen. And the sky darkens above you.
Yeah.
And black lightning bolts begin to shoot down in a circle around you. Your turn, sir.
Okay. I am going to
blueberry red, save us.
I'm gonna flip over all the witches, land on the becoming heart, stand on it, take all of the grenades off of my bandolier, put them all around the heart.
Uh-huh.
I'm gonna take my force axes, the two that I'm wielding, as well as the six that are down my legs, put them all into the heart because they'll function as shrapnel when I blow up the heart that I'm standing on.
Pretty awesome.
Sean
dates.
Do you yell, "Hey boys, I'm back"? Like Randy Quaid in Independence Day.
Yeah, I actually.
I'm back.
I flip onto the heart, I get up there, and I look at all of you guys, and I do a quick mental connection.
God damn it.
Oh, God.
So you guys get to experience
we
this.
We all have
its full
a single
glory.
Tear going down our face.
So when you make that connection, here's what happens is like it networks, you know, and once again, it networks all five of you.
Yeah.
But then all of a sudden, you see Ataria's helmet just go do-do-do-do, reconfigurating, and the three that go to them just all focus, super zoom. and all of a sudden on his visor.
It feels more powerful than normal.
You
actually.
Just see that fucking dog from Duck Hunt go, "Oh!"
I just started vomiting.
So you can pick five.
I turn into the matrix
code. A 12, an 8, a 10, and an 8, obviously.
Oh, okay, so I don't get to roll 5d12.
I Smith
no,
at
I
the
don't
end of
believe
the first
that. I don't believe that's the way it
okay,
works.
Okay, so a 12.
It's your system.
Because it's different trait dice for you, is, I believe. Is
who cares?
10.
Hashtag YOLO.
YOLO.
Hashtag.
Oh, I don't have the...
12, 10, 8, 6.
Three successes, the universe explodes.
Leave some of this fun for me, okay?
Oh, don't worry. I will not be remaining after this is over.
Those are your base ones. Are you using any of your powers? Or
I'm using my Outrider's Bandolier and my Force Axe.
Uh-huh, so that's a D10 and a D8.
This is the one time it doesn't work. We're like, wow.
That's an amazing plan. Right.
He was batting 1,000 until
then. Then we're going to drop 3 danger on you.
Okay, that's pretty much
Jesus Christ.
Expected.
I mean, honestly, we should probably drop more, but you got a handful of dice.
This
going
is going
to
be like Matthew McConaughey in
okay.
Fire.
Let's see what happens.
All right.
He's going to come out successful, though.
Okay.
Wow.
Oh, my fucking God. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
All but two.
So 8, and I'm actually going to spend these 6 for 6 additional successes, or 6 more hits. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That was.
Were you hoping to play around?
5, 6, 7.
Yeah,
eight,
but it's
six.
All good.
14 successes, 2 failures.
14 successes, 2 failures. All right. Well, you do get knocked unconscious.
Not surprising.
That's the final one that just does it.
Yeah.
Oh, that was the one.
All right.
Turn into a swan.
So, you nimbly leap up in the air, land on the head of Crane, mm-hmm. quickly hop over to the head of Rock, flip, do a backflip onto the shoulders of Stay, and do a curling spiral into the beckoning heart of Fuiha the Destroyer. In one swift somersault, you wrap your entire bandolier of grenades around around the heart, as well as festooning it with various force axes around the circumference.
And I hit the button on the hilt for each one, so they're all active.
And then, with just a mighty gleam in your eye, your chest tattoo lights up and says, "Your brain, are you using it?" And Atari is like, How do I get this off?
Just
it's just like melding into you.
Just a stream of vomit.
And it lights up and says, "Who cares?"
Yep.
And you hear a ding, hashtag ding, YOLO, boom. The shockwave of force that
kills
washes
me,
over
probably.
All of you knocks you flat against the ground, the cold, hard, rocky ground of the crater. There is a enormous kind of like crackling hum, as if the fabric of the universe itself was being torn apart. There's a vortex of wind that spins around the inside of the crater, and you hear, "Fwee-ha!"
Not me this time.
And suddenly,
you're sitting next to me yelling that.
Yeah.
It wasn't me. And you hear the screams and cries of the witches as they're sucked up into this giant black vortex, and it kind of pop into streamers of pink mist. Fuiha the Destroyer is slowly ground away, his flesh is ground away until his skeleton remains, and even then it crumbles into dust and is swept up into the sky. For a moment, you breathe a sigh of relief. There's a sudden thunderclap.
Whoop-boom!
They're all back.
The column of black swirling vortex mist dissipates, and standing in the center, you see the form of Balthamas.
"Thank you for bringing me here, my son. Now I will rule."
Yay!
I don't remember this part of Macbeth.
Yeah.
I remember the three witches.
Yeah. I'm flipping through the Great History of Gar.
Yeah, it's in the appendix.
What happens next will be determined the next time on Beastmasters of Yagamore!
Sugar Smack cereal commercial.
Hey folks, thank you for tuning in to another episode of Saving Throw Live. This is going to be our first episode of an actual campaign. No more one-shots.
Yay!